day in history. Death has beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive.
I was chairman of the new members process under Lydia, and we did it quite differently. As people who have been around that long know, we sat our new members down, and they had about a 3 or 4 hour session that kind of resembled being sold in timeshare. Not exactly, but kind of. And I think Rich's process now of doing it a little bit more open and a little freer is absolutely the way to go.
We've been coming for 10 years. But when Rich came on the scene, when he began to preach the word expositionally, I told my wife, we've got to get behind him. We're pretty old, but we can at least pray for him and support him. And the process was delightful, because the first thing the pastor did was to get up and say, you know, we're not trying to sell you a timeshare. We just want you to enjoy the fellowship that God has provided. And then meeting you, Jay, that was the creme de la creme.
Hi, my name is Mike Chase. What's your name?
Buzz.
This is Buzz Lightyear. I really appreciated the fact that this new members class was really personal. It wasn't sitting through a long lecture of church government and all the ins and outs of St. Andrew's, but more kind of getting to know each other in a personal way and over a meal and just kind of sharing life together and getting to know where each other are coming from. So it was good for us to learn that way and to really feel cared for. Cheryl was really good at looking for things to plug us into.
I think I like that it didn't feel like forced fun, you know, or canned kind of fun, which is good. It just felt pretty natural.
We had a dinner, we had a meal together, and that was great, great icebreaker, you know, just having conversation over dinner. We met then at the park. There were some new members and coaches met at a park. And it was great just hanging around, having conversation, getting to know the kids a little bit better, as well as Mike and Desi. Like Desi said, a real comfortable situation. And then my family got the chance to babysit Josiah and Rosie. And we really got to connect with them. And my kids got to connect with their kids.
Did you go to Cheryl's house?
I go to Cheryl's house. I passed her kids. As I could play toys.
I remember just walking down the street one day, Desi and I were out for a walk, and we ran into Cheryl at a school parking lot, and it was great just to stop and talk, and that was just a real kind of spontaneous meetup, and we had some great conversation and just about our lives and things we're learning. And so it was really cool too, just how the Lord orchestrated things outside of what we scheduled to meet up and continue conversation.
It's been really neat because there's some people like Todd and Ileana that have been around a while that we've gotten to know a little better. And there's been some people that we've seen around church, maybe didn't even know their names. And by this time, we've had an opportunity to hang out with them, go to the park with our families, let the kids get to know each other.
Something I really liked about this type of arrangement of the new members group was that a lot of times you'll meet somebody, and then you'll meet one of their kids, and then you'll meet another kid, and it's kind of, you meet them in pieces, and it's hard to get to know the whole family together. It was nice that we hung out as families, and you see the kids with the parents, and that was fun. I've been going to St. Andrew's since junior high school. I really didn't know that there was new member stuff out there. It was made kind of a big deal this year, which I thought was really good. And the way that it came together with having people like Tempest and Corey to come alongside us and just make sure that we were involved and keeping tabs on us was really good.
For me, when I joined the church and did the new members class at St. Andrew's, it was pretty educational, but it kind of felt like they give us a meal, you know, and then we went in the sanctuary and heard this kind of lecture on, you know, Presbyterianism and everything, and just kind of fighting to stay awake. And I didn't really, when I joined the church as a new member, it didn't really cause me to be able to meet anybody else or to get plugged in any better. And I think this way, it's a much more personable way to do it. And it's a much easier way for someone that whether they're like Todd, they've been here a while, or especially if they're fairly new to the church, it's a really good chance for them to get plugged in.
I thought it was really fun because the Conwishers were also one of the new member coaches. And so we planned a park day with them and another couple of coaches and all their people. And it was really fun, I think, for people to get to know Rich and Kelly and their kids on that kind of level in the park.
I thought it was great to meet Rich right off the bat. The new style of having somebody as a coach has been great from the standpoint that if there's really a question that I have, if there's really a doubt I have, I know that there's somebody who I won't feel like I'm bothering them to ask what's going on. And I know that I could call Corey anytime and just ask him about an event that's going on, or ask him about a question I have in faith, or anything of that manner, and I know that he'd be there. And that's really nice because I am plugged in with somebody at the church.